This is Mike Nagami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. Today's theme is Why has Lean Sigma been spreading so much in the world? Lean came from the Toyota production system. Six Sigma is a production management method developed by Motorola. Since both methodologies came from manufacturing companies, many of you may think that Lean Sigma is only for manufacturing. Of course, it was mainly used by those departments at the time, at the beginning. But here in America, because this is a multi-ethnic country and there are not many business stereotypes compared to Japan, people didn't think this is just for manufacturing industry. So Lean Sigma was largely utilized in non-manufacturing industries. I'm going off topic now a little bit, but I think that when you go to a sushi restaurant in the US, you will be surprised by their huge selection of sushi rolls. Most restaurants create their own special sushi rolls freely, so each restaurant has 30 or 40 kinds of sushi rolls. I'm Japanese, and we may have a stereotyped image of sushi. People here in the US see things differently. So I could learn a lot from people's flexibility and imagination here. Thanks to the American people's flexibility, Lean Sigma scientific process improvement has been applied to non-manufacturing sectors such as office work and service departments. Even more, this methodology makes us think how we can make our repetitive work or any process in our day-to-day operations faster, more productive, and cheaper. Thinking of different industries, the IT, financial, and medical industries in the US lately utilize Lean Sigma greatly. Many large companies establish a process improvement department in their headquarters and hire Lean Sigma belts. They conduct total process analysis company-wide and subsidiary-wide and have achieved total optimization. Along the way, Lean Sigma belts in global companies are traveling all over and playing an active role around the world. Lean Sigma belts are increasing globally. For the past several years, there has been a boom in hospitals introducing Lean Sigma. I came to the US in 2001. At that time, it was common to wait a few hours in the hospital. Recently, we really need to wait that long and feel the result of Lean Sigma. A matter of fact, my company is in the food industry and has operated the employee cafes of large companies. It is very far from the manufacturing industry. I use my Lean Sigma skills every day and put out the results in a number of improvements. Recently, my division CEO told me to train and provide 100 green belts in the future. That motivates me very much. I will talk about how I utilize Lean Sigma in my work later on. So today's theme is why has Lean Sigma been spreading so much in the world? I'll cut to the chase to answer that question. It's because Lean Sigma has come up with a number of achievements in non-manufacturing industries. I don't know the actual numbers, but the number of people in general who are working in non-manufacturing departments are far more than those who are working in manufacturing departments, obviously. Since those people in non-manufacturing departments have introduced this scientific method in their process improvements, many departments, many companies, many industries, and many countries have achieved many improvements to projects with Lean Sigma. There is no reason that Lean Sigma cannot spread all over the world. However, there is only one exception to that among other countries. It is my own country, Japan. I would like to tell the Japanese people, try using this methodology in your non-manufacturing department, then you'll get tremendous results. Thank you very much for listening. Also, please click the subscribe button around here. Bye.